Hello everyone, Mr. Happy here, and welcome to my patch 3.5 Anima Weapon Overview. This step of the Anima Weapon will increase the item level of the weapon from I-260 to I-270. Fortunately, it's not too bad of a step, so once you have the I-260 weapon, head to Azus Law and grab the next quest from Ardashir. The first thing he'll have you do is run 3 hard mode dungeons, Lost City of Amdapur hard mode, Great Google Library hard mode, and Samal hard mode. Keep in mind you must be on the same job you accepted the quest as when doing these dungeons. Meaning, hey, I want to do my monk relic. I need to do these dungeons on monk. But you don't need to have the weapon equipped, thankfully. Just being in your inventory or armory chest is just fine. Once you complete these 3 dungeons, you'll need to complete 2 more tasks before the weapon is complete. The first is to collect 15 Numenites. These can be obtained in a number of different ways. 200 lore or poetic tomestones per piece, 4,000 grand company seals, or even as drops from treasure maps. Either way, once you collect 15 Numenites, you can bring them back to the quest giver to obtain a newborn soulstone. The other quest you'll need to do is reminiscent of the light farming step from the A Realm Reborn relic. By completing duties with your item level 260 animal weapon equipped, you need it equipped this time, you will obtain what are known as lights. This is a designated message that you get upon defeating the final boss of an instance. Once you have acquired all the lights needed, you'll receive a message that lets you know your weapon's etheric energy is nigh unyielding, meaning you have completed the weapon. Progress can be tracked via your Anima Glass key item, which shows a total of 10 runes. The more runes that are fully lit, the closer you are to completion. In case you're looking to get some actual numerical values behind the light farming, here you go. You need a total of 1,000 lights to complete the grind. Each time you complete a duty, you'll receive a flat value based on the message you receive. If it tells you you received Vague Lights, it gives you 1, Meager Lights gives 2, Vigorous gives 4, Robust gives 6, Sturdy gives 12, Hardened gives 24, and Stalwart gives 48. On top of that, while every instance has its own predetermined base values, sometimes you can receive a bonus, giving you a stronger message than normal. Every 2 hours, which instances give bonuses will change, but luckily there's a Reddit live thread where players input what values instances are currently worth. You can also sometimes receive bonus lights even when something isn't in bonus, but at a greatly reduced rate.
So I already know the next question. What's the best thing to farm?
It seems that A1 Savage is easily the best way to farm these lights currently. At default, it rewards Robust Light, meaning it takes a maximum of 167 runs to complete, each of which usually only takes about 3 minutes. However, when in bonus, it's Sturdy, doubling the lights and cutting the runs in half to a mere 84. You'll find yourself on average taking somewhere between 5 to 10 hours, depending on if A1 Savage is in bonus or not, and that's not including if you take time to do other content for lights. And don't worry about the "I've never done Savage before." It's not a problem. A1 Savage dies so fast, you'll never need to do mechanics, just dodge all the AoEs. People even love the occasional lore bonus. Once you've completed the light farming, take that and your newborn soulstone back to Azus Law to complete the weapon. There's even a follow-up quest that rewards an Anima minion. While the questline says that the Anima Saga is over, Yoshi-P has recently said there will be another step in a later patch. Whether that remains to be true, we shall see. Overall, I'd say this is the easiest of the super hard steps the Anima has ever had. It's significantly easier than both the original 210 and 240 steps, and is even considerably easier than most of the A Realm Reborn Zodiac steps. Once the Umbrite and Aether Oil steps are nerfed in the next 2 months or so, the Anima Weapon should actually be a pretty easy grind from beginning to end. And that's going to be it for my Anima Weapon overview for patch 3.5. Best of luck on your light farming. I know plenty of people have been completing weapons left and right. Heck, I think it was even A1 Savage was in bonus for like 6 hours and somebody completed their weapon from beginning to end in under that. And honestly, it's easy to do. Be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share, and stay tuned for all the latest Final Fantasy XIV information, news, overviews, guides, all that good stuff. Anyway, I'll see you in the next one, and until then, take care.